Hello, today I will give you information of polymerase chain reaction, that is PCR test. PCR test is used in the clinical laboratory to detect presence of specific DNA or RNA of a microorganism in a specimen like blood, serum, CSF, semen, urine, etc. By PCR test, it is possible to detect nanoparticles in specimen in the form of RNA or DNA of viruses, bacteria and fungi. Most important feature of PCR is when ELISA test is indeterminate, means it fails to diagnose a specific case definitely, PCR or RT-PCR test is used to confirm diagnosis of diseases like COVID-19, malaria, chikungunya, dengue fever, HIV, etc. By means of PCR technology, it is possible to generate sufficient quantities of DNA by increasing the number of copies of specific target region of DNA. And at the end of PCR experiment, over a million copies of the original DNA of interest can be obtained in the form of copy of DNA, which is called as cDNA. What are the requirements for PCR test? For PCR test, you require a specimen in the form of either blood, serum, throat swab, sputum, semen, etc. and diagnostic kit. Diagnostic kit contains primers. Primers means short sequences of DNA that flank the target sequence of interest, which is shown here on the left hand side, and thermostable DNA polymerase, very important enzyme which catalyzes DNA production. Then you require a buffer system which contains specific concentration of magnesium chloride and deoxynucleotide triphosphate DNTPs such as DATP, DGTP, DCTP and DTTP, which compose DNA, and PCR equipment, that is thermal cycler, which is used to form millions of copies of the target DNA. DNA fragments are used to make multiple copies of the DNA, and the most important enzyme, thermus aquaticus. This enzyme is actually cloned from Pyrococcus furiosus, an organism that grows optimally in geothermal marine sediment at 100 degrees temperature. That means this enzyme remains stable during the entire thermal cycler temperatures, 60 degrees to 90 degrees temperature. And why the human DNA polymerase is not used? Because it will remain stable only at body temperature, and above 40 to 50 degrees temperature, our body DNA polymerase will get denatured. And then DNTPs are used to make multiple components of the DNA copies. Now let us see how PCR test is carried out. First, in a specific tube, sample is mixed with the PCR reagent containing EDTA, lysosome and sodium dodecyl sulfate. EDTA inhibits activity of interfering DNases, and lysosome and sodium dodecyl sulfate break cells in the specimen and release DNA or RNA. And in the next step, chloroform and isoamyl alcohol mixture added to precipitated DNA, and one reagent which contains RNAs is added to remove interfering RNAs, and then this mixture is centrifuged at 12,000 G to get precipitate of DNA. To the precipitate of DNA, a buffer solution is added which contains primers and the enzyme thermus aquaticus, that is DNA polymerase. And the ependrof which contains this mixture is then placed on PCR instrument, that is thermal cyclase, to produce copies of DNA in 20 cycles, which contain following steps: denaturation, annealing, and extension of DNA, as shown in the figure on the left hand side. Once copies of DNA are obtained, Southern blot electrophoresis is performed by agarose gel electrophoresis using a positive control DNA and a negative control DNA. These separated DNA fractions then stained using fluorescent dye, ethyridium bromide. Base pair lengths of separated DNAs can be determined by using UV trans illuminator. And when base pair length, BP length of test matches with positive control, test is positive, otherwise it is negative. For information of electrophoresis and dot blot techniques, kindly refer to our third edition of Medical Laboratory Technology book, chapter 4 and pages 91, 94 and 103. Well, this figure indicates summary of PCR test, and following page indicates limitations of PCR test. Hence, RT-PCR test is more sensitive and specific, and in the following part, I will explain you COVID-19 RT-PCR test. It is very important to note here that for PCR and RT-PCR test, a highly specialized laboratory section is used with restricted entries. In this section, class 3 bioseptic cabinets are used, and sterilized glassware, plasticware, and type 1 reagent grade water free from all sorts of contaminations like DNases and RNases, which may be harmful to RNA or DNA, and other various advantages of PCR I have listed on the left hand side. Now I will give you information of RT-PCR test. All the requirements for RT-PCR are exactly the same as for PCR, except in the last stage, instead of electrophoresis and autoradiography, spectrophotometric rate of reaction method is used for DNA determination. For this purpose, one dye, cyber green, is added in the master mix of the lyophilized reagent, and this dye, when binds the single strand of DNA, very less light of green color is emitted. However, in polymeric chain reaction, when double-stranded DNA molecules keep on forming, cyber green emits intense green light, which is proportional to the size of DNA molecules, and it can be read spectrophotometrically very accurately. Now I will give you information of COVID-2019 RT-PCR test. These are all the requirements of the test. Diagnostic kit contains specific tubes in which lyophilized reagent mixture is placed. It contains all the chemical requirements explained in the PCR test, like buffer solution, specific COVID primers, NTPs, DNA polymerase, cyber green, and one additional enzyme, reverse transcriptase. COVID-19 virus is positive sense RNA virus, and it must be converted into double-stranded DNA for polymerase chain reaction. And for that purpose, reverse transcriptase enzyme is used, which converts single-stranded RNA into double-stranded DNA. Most important requirement is patient's throat swab. and other requirements required are specific high speed centrifuge, vortex mixer, safety cabinet and thermal cycler to carry out RT-PCR chain reactions, equipped with spectrophotometer to read rate of reaction related to cyber green dye. Well, procedure is like this. First, patient's throat swab is collected and by using a specific swab and transferred to a specific transport medium. Then, 8 lyophilized tubes are placed on the stand, 2 for positive controls, 2 for negative controls, 1 for normal patient sample and 3 for patient's throat swab sample. Next, in the tubes, reagent grade water is added to dissolve the powder form of reagent mix. Afterwards, control sample, normal and patient samples are added in the respective labeled tubes. These are then vortex mixed and then centrifuged. Respective DNA strands are now present. All these tubes, all labeled tubes, are placed in thermal cyclers and readings are obtained as shown on the left hand side. And first exponential part of the graph is considered for the reading. If COVID-19 is absent, no significant fluorescence is detected as per guidelines and as given in the manual. But if COVID-19 is present, then you will get significant fluorescence and related graph. It is important to note here that for 20 cycles of PCR procedure, about 3 hours are required. Since for one cycle, time required is 4 minutes for denaturation, 2 minutes for annealing and 2 minutes of extension of DNA, total 8 minutes. Hence, for 20 cycles, about 160 minutes are required. Another important feature you must know is RT-PCR test can be performed by one-step method or two-step method as shown in the figure. In one-step method, all the reactions are carried out once, while in the two-step method, first viral RNA is converted to copy of cDNA by reverse transcriptase enzyme and then PCR procedure is followed. And remember, two-step method is more accurate and more sensitive. And students, I'm sure you all must be doing well and safe. Now it's time for the preparation of examination and related questions I have placed on the left hand side. Answers, of course, all you will get in this presentation. And thank you all of you for supporting our educational channel, and kindly subscribe and share all our videos with your friends, and don't forget to refer our textbooks. Have a good day.